and welcome to FaceCheck. I'm going back into Hacknet this evening. Last time the game ended when I couldn't connect to my ISP to change my IP address. I've looked it up. I believe the issue is something permanent, and the only way to fix it is to uninstall and reinstall the game, start again, delete your save. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to just drop back into whatever the game puts me last. I can't remember when I last saved. I don't know how much time I'm going to lose. But I think the game is only 5-6 hours long anyway, even with my terrible slow start and talking over the top. So here I will just save after every mission that I go on, or every computer that I hack into. And then if I do get that the trace coming back to me again, even if I can't actually fix it, I won't have lost too much time by restarting. So wait and see if anybody ends up watching. Just give it 5 minutes or so. excuse me, although 5 minutes is a lifetime online. It seems that Twitch is a good keyword to use on Twitter. Get a number of people just retweeting you for no good reason. Just looking to pick up followers, no doubt. Anyway, I've been enjoying Hacknet so far, but I can't really remember any of the commands anymore. I'm also not too sure about where I left the game and what I'm supposed to be doing. So while we're waiting here, I'm going to just log into a few things and set up the shells. And then if I, as always, is that my IP? Is my computer here? 150. Wow, there's loads of things left in there. Sorry, I'm space. Delete all them. I actually think disconnecting leaves a log, so I'm just gonna move on from that. So I've got there. If I get this fella's PC, log in, shell that one. Now, if I remember, there wasn't a lot of things I had to overload last time, but I'm best to have like 3 or 4 just set up. I've watched the videos back. The microphone's a little far away from me, but there's not too much I can do without having it actually in front of the screen, so you just have to deal with it. And I believe the only sound you can hear in terms of the game is the sound that comes from the speaker, so I've turned that up a little bit. Hopefully it's not too distracting. Joseph Scott, log in here. I'll get 4 shell computers here. And that'll do me. I'm still able to run 2 thingies. So there's the ISP server. Now, is that a different IP than the one I was trying to log into? I wonder. I'm gonna head over there. Log in. So I can log in, complete that, and then should we have a scan? Nothing. Okay, so let's just delete the fact I was here. So I'm able to log into that anytime. Maybe I can do it kind of semi automagically. Now I just want one more computer somewhere. Maybe not that. Viper's battle station will do it. Shell that. 4's enough. So that should still let me run 1 big program and or 2 small programs. Learn that you don't actually need the forward slash when changing directories. Okay, it's kind of set up. I'm going to go back into my emails here. Jailbreak. So does the game auto save after You succeed in one, so that's not too bad. Yeah, because it was the EOS thingy, wasn't it? So EOS, E. Yeah, so if I get into the computer again and do that. Sure, so let's save the session there. And then Sal's computer's there. And... right, that's fine. So we're saved. I know what I'm up to. Let's see if anybody's watching. Probably not. Just retweet bots. I'm currently live at least. I think changing the quality up to 720p didn't make a lot of difference, but let's actually start playing the game. So, Sal's workstation. I'm in. Scan. See if I can find his phone. While I'm waiting, let's have a little look around again. So there's one device found, so I've now found the phone. So I know roughly what I'm doing. Just double check if there's anything worth having a look at. I think I've read these before. So what did you get up to this weekend? Not much, Jerry's out of town. An affair. Lab nightmare. Cell count much higher. Genetic. Okay, let's pop into the log. And then let's just delete the fact I was here. Now, let's head over here and start with a cheeky little probe. So three for the thingy. So instead I'll go back, and the login was admin and the password was Alpine. Okay, by the way, so not probe this time, LS. All these games look amazing. Zombie Violence Saga, one of my favorites. IDs, registration. Now I can't quite remember what it was I was supposed to find. What if I run this EOS thing again? Should have reread the wee thingy. So password is 22 Foxhound. 22 Foxhound. I think that's what I'm after. But I'll need to log out and have a look in a minute. Let me fire up the notes on my phone again. Might be a little easier if I had two computers. Or, well, not two computers, but a second screen. I'm only rocking a single screen. Because the graphics card only has one output. See what else I can find while I'm in here just before I log out. Nothing. Home. Nothing. Bin, nothing. Sys, nothing. Right, so delete the fact I was ever here. Let's have a nothing exit. And I can exit that as well, so let's manually exit those. Okay. So let's head back to the mail server. They're calling a registration ID. No, maybe that was... there, view file system, registration ID, notes IDs. Right, so actually that's what I was after here. So it's AAX1BB7. Now those are Steam codes there, but I'm going to assume they've been long used by people. I guess this was a giveaway for a game. I'll maybe look that up later. Or maybe they're in fact like just DLC codes, the reusable DLC codes. I'm not going to make a note of those just now because it doesn't seem to be an easy way to copy them. But I'll tell you what, I'll copy them back to my workstation, and that way I can always get them later. And get rid of those. And now that I know the answer, once you have the ID, respond with it here. So it was AAX1BB7. Successful. Ooh, flag for critical contract. I'll read that in a second. Contract successful. Current ranking 38 of 100. Super. Right, flag for critical contract. Agent. Administrators have flagged your account with permissions to accept the critical contract. Yes, Project Junebug on the listings page. Be aware that accepting this contract may be either time-consuming or require confidentiality and a separation from other projects for a time, and should be undertaken only with the expectation that other contracts and possibly C6 services may be unavailable for its duration. Okay, so this is obviously the next stage. So if I head over to the... it's not Crossroads I want, it is the contracts. Log in. So Junebug's there. Is it worth doing all these other ones before moving on to Project Junebug? I wonder. Now, if I don't do these, I presume I can come back to them and do them after, but am I likely to get any extra tools or anything to do it? I'd assume not, because it lets me do it, and if you don't have the right tools. So let's save after having successfully done that. As I said, if I get traced, there might not be the option to fix it, although now that I know where that ISP management server is, maybe I can. Right, Project Junebug. Advance 3 times, do 6 net damage for 1 credit. An incredibly delicate situation has come up, requiring the involvement of a skilled anonymous outside agent, willing to be responsible for some questionable actions to greatly help an individual in need. Well, that sounds like me. Okay, I'm in. Let's play. It's the next stage of the game. Alright, what is it? Hacker, this isn't a normal request, and we're not going to treat it as such. We've been asked to perform a euthanasia. Obviously, we sent out a few others to dig up data on it. Data. And a few from outside groups so as to not to raise suspicion some time ago. And largely speaking, it's come back all clear. It seems the man in question, one Elliot Whitt, is hospitalised in considerable pain and, against his wishes, has been denied the option of death. A failed attempt by his family earlier has prevented them from performing subsequent efforts until a member proposed this option. It seems the pacemaker he's fitted with allows remote access, with proper authorization, and they believe this may be an avenue to fulfill this request. Naturally, given the nature of this request, we can accept that you don't want to be involved. Reply with deny in your response and we will remove you from the project. If you do decide to help us with this matter, you should know it will likely take some amount of investigation and testing, given that as far as we know, this has never before been attempted. We recommend starting with the target's medical record, identifying the chip, looking for its manufacturers and going from there. Okay, so that's the medical, and that's just notes. So, you know, I don't need you anymore. If I close that, does that free up any? Oh, there's loads of things in here. Maybe that's why it uses up all my memory. Delete all files in the log, yeah. Security basics, yeah, got that. A few notes on proxy servers, yeah. Oh, there's tons of notes in here, I never realised. Oops, project details, there you go. Action euthanasia. Okay, so Elliot Whitt. I think I can maybe get away with leaving that open. Okay, so now I know why notes are taking up so much space. You have to close them when you're done. So target's medical record, and then looking for its manufacturers. Okay. Now, there's probably going to be some decent security on here. Let's go with overload, 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 and then... Well, that's not started any anything bad there. So, what do I think the password is going to be here? W8 Medicate, I think. Medicate, yeah. So, solve Medicate. Solve successful proxy bypassed. Okay, so that's the first couple of steps done. Now, let's start on this, and if we FTP bounce 21, run both of those at the same time. I wonder what this medical services port does. I need 4 to crack it, so I don't need to do that just yet. That's fine. SMTP port 25, insufficient memory. It's fine. Let that go, and then SQL and memory corrupt 1433, but again, that's not going to have enough space. And we're in, and then port hack. Oh, it's all coming back to me. Could be a real hacker soon. Just wait for that to go green. Start the port hack. See if we can get the password, and we are in. So if I want to, well, let's have a look at the info. Might as well just use the web interface here. So it is Elliot Witt search. So blood type BO, is that a real blood type or is that a joke? Age 54. 150, okay, yeah, got you. Height 5'5", it's only wee. Heart rate regulation. Okay, so ivermectin. So there's the pacemaker connection. Do 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 do. Right, so due to recurring and critical arrhythmia. Never had to say that word before. Arrhythmetic problems in the patient's heart, they've been fitted with a pacemaker that can allow some fine tuning to account for unknown variables. Right, so pacemaker 202.6.141.219. Check, and then add notes doc 66.96. Put space in there, 66.96.147.84. Okay, so start there. And then extra details before taking any action that might disrupt the pacemaker or performing any invasive surgery, contact the manufacturers to confirm its stability. So what's the name of the company? So he's in a London private hospital in the UK, just down the road. How do I know the... Okay, well, let's come out of that. I wonder... A lot of information there. What was Bip's real name? I wonder if there's any information on... him in here. Don't know. Now there seemed to be a medical tool, default boot module. Interesting. Log on. Not so keen on that. I was kind of hoping to get a tool there, but let's come out of that. Actually, I'm gonna have to perform a scan. Never scanned the thingy before then. Scanning, scan complete, and then file not found, bin log. Okay, so connect to, let's go see the documentation first, 0.84. Interesting, firmware and patching, remote tools. Yep. Right. So this pacemaker remote tools. This post details the remote monitoring update functionality of the V2.44 pacemaker. For general operations, consult the hard copy documentation or request another copy from support@kellisbio.com. Don't suppose I'll need a hard copy of that. The Kellis Biotech V2.44 pacemaker, hear out pacemaker, is designed for patients that are considered a high risk or need consistent monitoring but are unable to remain in a hospital. The pacemaker can be connected to remotely, providing the observer with real-time ECG data and some small clerical update tools. Given the sensitive nature of the system, requiring 100% uptime, the system is hardlocked to only accept binary update packages signed by the build server of the chip's assigned software designer. Okay. Updates are generally only provided on a case-specific basis, in which a patient may need slightly different settings to account for natural change in cardiac rhythm in response to age or operation. Kelsey's updating system makes these changes possible without need for further intrusive operation, although prior versions of the chip included tools for manually updating settings. These have been removed for security concerns, and this current version only allows pacemaker behaviour changes to be made via firmware patch, which can be done wirelessly to remove the need for surgery. Okay. Security and clearances. This post details the security functionality of the pacemaker. Clearing security to perform a firmware update once a signed binary has been retrieved from the software developers requires several steps. First, connect to the pacemaker chip using the patient's reference IP address. Well, that I have. Log in as an administrator using details that have been assigned on a per case basis by the client. This step is protected using Kelsey's proprietary microport protection system, port 6652. This note function's actually not so bad now. At this stage, remote monitoring will be enabled, allowing the user to view live ECG data. To perform the firmware update, a secondary software login must be performed using an authorized software manufacturer's authentication code. With both details confirmed, then we can do something. Automatically soft reset and activate the new codes. Let's add another note here. So, central server. So, central server is 111.105.22.1. As only build signed and is written there by their internal services, using our key will run on the chips. No other company can produce working code for the chips without having them compile it. Issues with the remote monitor software and internet, yeah, blah, blah, blah. Okay, that's not too disinteresting. I wonder if there's more to it. Okay, well, that's... got a little bit of time here. Bio something. Solve bio gel, and then I want webworm 80. You can get running there, and then FTP 21, and then SSH 2. I don't think I've got enough time to get out. Right, so then I disconnected. Now I don't know if that will work for me, but if I go back here, probe. Oh, I got to do it all again. Oh no, that's not where I want to be, is it? So notes. I want to connect. So that's all done. Okay, so I actually need to bust this bit before disconnecting. I don't need to get in and get all the stuff. So that's interesting. And then I can do this and get back out, I suppose. So that's fine. Let's just delete all this while I'm here. And then if I disconnect... did I see where that... Oh, there's a point clicker. I'm going to go back to that and play it at some point. And then connect. to that, and then ls, and then I'm in. Yeah, that's fine. So if I need to take that down, that's possible. Using the server, so that's just what I see already. Nothing in there. Under the home folder, walkthrough. Grocery Simulator 2010. Nice. So these all games that the designers previously made. Nothing in there. Nothing in there. Default boot module. I wonder if that's worth having. No, that's fine. Log. Remove any trace of me being here. And then let's go to the central server, see what we can find. So a little probe, see what we can see. So let's close this for the time being. And then. Perfect. And then once I get the last one in, it's fine. Port hack there. It's fine. Get rid of these. I've probably got enough time to do this anyway, but all I'm going to do is bounce between here and here, and then stops the countdown. Okay, so this is easier than I maybe first thought. Well, these are interesting. Synergistic cloud glass ceiling breaker. Test guide. Part of test cycle before running a unit test suite on a chip, a cycle check needs to be performed. Hook it up to the test station, run the cycler as its firmware first. After it's run, dump the data to the station. You can go ahead and flash it and patch in your new test. Current signed testing firmware named Pacemaker Firmware Cycle Test.dll. Do not upload it to any deploy ready devices. Okay, well, I'm going to have that. Pacemaker Firmware Cycle Test.dll. So I'll copy that. Pacemaker firmware cycle test.dll. Mine. Sweet. And you got the different firmware packages here as well. And internal goals. That's some real blue sky thinking from those guys there. Island security notes. Ah, that's interesting. Idle e-admin. Okay, so this gets me me, so let's add notes, and that will be e-admin 1086. Oh, add note, let's get right. E-admin 86. Okay. Okay. All right. Nothing there. Nothing there. Anything under home? Another log. That's just data. Data from France. Sure, let's just empty this. Got a fair bit of information going now. Let me then try. It's Universal Medical, which led me to here, which led me to here. Is it worth trying to have a little look at the pacemaker itself? View monitor. So admin login. So is this going to get me in? Login failed. Okay, well, let's have a probe instead. So some medical services. How did I get that? So that login didn't work, and remote monitor. So view monitor. Admin access required. Admin login. And those are the details I don't currently know. So registration 10811. I wonder if that's off use. Cancel that, cancel, cancel. Yeah, definitely not got anything that will get me through there. Have I not logged into this already? What? You sure I've not logged into this already? I feel an awful lot like I have logged into this already. What do I want? Analyze. Yeah, it's Medicaid. So. Medicaid. And then, fine, we'll do it again, see if I care. Not enough space. I can close that for time being, I suppose. That'll work. Port 21, and finally is SQL 22, and 1433. And if I hack into here. Was the fella's name again? Whit Elliott. Let's fire back up the notes. Might as well put that back. Right, so cool, cool beans, cool beans. Nice, there's not much else to learn there, I guess. Is there anything here that's not a record? Maybe something that's a program? Don't see why there would be, but you never know. Okay. Telling on Twitch, DDoS Cyber, hi. Your username worries me slightly, but let's not move on from there. If you've played Hacknet before, I'll take a hint. Don't give me the answers, but by all means, you know, type something in chat. Let me know what I'm supposed to be doing. I'm pretty sure I scanned this already. That's fine. So CD dot dot. CD log, remove any trace of me being here. That's all those deleted. Let's go in here. Didn't scan on this one. Nothing. So what are all these files? Test guides. I've got that. But idle on security. Testing functions. Idle on support admin. 1088. Permissions all. So this isn't actually them, it's Kellis. If I take a beta version of this software, KBT, pacemaker, firmware, underscore 0.1.dll. Let's take a copy of that, see how it goes. No tips from DDoS Cyber yet. And I suppose if I upload like the version 1 beta, that's enough to crash it, I would presume. Maybe just gonna take that driver config file as well. Don't know if it's useful or not. .config. Okay, there's a whole bunch of stuff that I've got. Excuse me. Synergistic cloud glass ceiling breaker. Nope. Yeah, it's just No. Alright, so let's have a look at this again. So, test guide. Part test cycle check needs to be performed. I need to get into the thing itself, so I need a username password, I guess. So I guess I just need to run this. Not quite sure how to upload a DLL file, but that is okay. Right, so you can upload fine once I'm in there. It's a KBTS file. Interesting. Right, so I just need the password. So if this is... No. Tried that though, didn't get me anywhere. Yeah, I don't know if new products. Full privileges and testing functions. So we'll go back to here. Let's do a quick scan. Nothing. New file system. Log. Right, let's just delete those for time being. And then, well, can I run it from the Biotech Client Services server? Let's find out. Alright, let's head over here. Default boot module walkthrough. Oh, this is the. It's not the walkthrough I'm after. So what am I missing? Port 6652. So the medical ones are on. So I don't have a medical. Using the service, which shows out products. Login. Admin gators. What if I... there's no real choice there. Scan network. Hello, hello. The asset server, yes. So let's view logs and then let's just lose those. Okay, so this will probably be a more protected server. Scan function. So let's just start by actually kind of just log in. Eadmin 1086. Failed. Okay, worth a punt. Still don't really know what the thing is for. So this could go quite quickly. So let's close you. And that should be okay. And we're off. And some BI Biogel. Oh, I've been here before, right? But yeah, I've not had a play around the server again, so that's fine. And these are all the ones I need, and then just port hack. Why doesn't it remember the password? Strange. Get this one in. And then just get the password. Now just bounce between the servers. And log in. Complete. So just bounce here, bounce here. Weird. Suppose it's fine. Yeah, so let's see what's on here again. Nothing, nothing, nothing. Oh, let's have a look at the log. Who stole the cookie from the cookie jar? Here we go. So now we've got the port test.exe. Sweet. So let's grab that to start with. Mine. So KBT is probably a shortcut for that. Read me. Kellis Biotech Port Tester. I guess this could be the thing I need. So the KBPT is a utility made for testing and stressing the Kellis Medical Standard port 104. This tool can be deployed with a hardware package on request to test the device under scrutiny. It's designed to flood the port with traffic, including that of outside sources, some of which the program pulls in itself. So also, this should not be used on live devices, though they are tested by Kellis locally. Applying unnecessary stress on components and codes is not responsible behaviour. Okay, well, I've got the port hack there. Media pack, don't really need that. Any other tools? Nope. Okay, so happy with that. And now let's see if I can find this fella's pacemaker again, wherever it was. This is it here. So let's probe again. And then KBT port 104. Okay, oh, it's doing something. Oh, there's some new colours. I should maybe update the theme. I did download a theme. Getting there. Man, that's a tough one to crack. Okay, so let's see what's in here, shall we? Login. Wait, cancel. Port hack. Obs, still not actually logged in. Sweet. Okay, so. But blood pressure 133/97. Is that good? I don't know. Firmware. Login first. So is this where get my notes back? Login. Eadmin and 1086. Oops. Retry that. Login complete. So version 1. Now, what did I download? Readme. Invalid binary package. Valid firmware must be digitally signed by author. Can I upload here? No, now what was it supposed to run? Ugh, so the port tester got me in. What was the thing not to run, the DLL? Standby, I want to, let's quickly check out here, view my own file system. The package was this one. So if I just add a note, it is KBT _ pacemaker firmware _ 0.1.dll. So just add that as a note, and then I'll pop back to this fella here. Admin login. The monitor login. Administrate firmware. So upload. Pacemaker firmware. That's not what I wanted at all. Maybe I didn't need that dot dot. Yeah, let me just pop back. I don't think that was what I was actually after. Logs I wanted, it was, yeah, this one, pacemaker. Right, that was a mistake, so let's try that again. Pacemaker firmware cycle test.dll, and then we'll pop back here, new monitor, login. Wait, so if we go to firmware, and then I want to upload pacemaker firmware cycle test.dll. Not found its specified path. Where? How do I get back to home for uploading stuff? Where's a file dump? Drop server. Upload, so just home, view monitor, login, if I just firmware, let's try this, not found its specified file path, pacemaker firmware, cycle test, okay, so it's, and then let's see if that appears. Transfer complete. Currently active firmware. Yeah, I mean, I'm in. So I can't upload to this. Valid firmware file. Who knows what will happen running this one? Probably nothing. So now that's a problem. So it says it's uploaded, but it's not there. Secondary security layer for firmware read write access. Can I swap the contents of this? Firmware _2.dll. It's a file not found. Ah. Hold up. So it's fine. So actually I want to upload it in here. Dope. Let's cover more tracks, let's not forget. Pacemaker, firmware. Yeah, this makes more sense doing it in here anyway. Test.dll. Done, and then remove the other file. KBT _ pacemaker, firmware. 0.1.dll, get rid of that as well. And then if we go into here, and then if we upload this one, and then come back out, log in, complete, remote monitor, view monitor, firmware, here it is, boom, activate. And this will be the end of them. Now I'm hoping I've somewhat done the right thing here. They've not just sent me to murder someone. Yeah, euthanasia. Interesting topic. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Two, 300, 400 beats per minute. 500. It's off the chart. Send to him. I was never here. See if I can get out in time. Semi tempted to remove the firmware file. No, it's fine. Done. Reply. Contract successful. You're 19 of 100. Free to accept further contracts. Great success. Bit Foundation. From Bit. Hey, so this is a bit unorthodox, but I pulled some strings. You'll be the one that did the Bit contract before, looking for what happened there. I'm after some more information and I wanted the same person on it. If you're getting this, it means you've just finished your assigned contract, so we're good to go. To be frank, the term pulling strings with CSEC isn't something you really use lightly, and in this case it's even more so. You got results fast and I want you on this case too. More collaboratively this time. If I sound confident you'll want to join in here, I've good reason for it. There's a very substantial incentive waiting for you on the CSEC asset server. Look for tracekill.deck, decrypt it with the password DX. Okay, well let's bin you, add a note, and then DX122DX. Okay, tracekill.deck. Asset server, login, complete, new file system, bin, gimme, and then, so I need the cipher. Tracekill. Deck password DX122. Actually, now let's tell you what, let's head over here. That's not what I want. Home. Mutant2DX. Checking the file not found. Uppercase, lowercase. In my lady's chamber. Okay, I tell you what, let's save this while we're here. As I said, if I ever get stung, maybe I can get away with it by going there, but you don't know. And now I've got this XE here. I need to copy that again. Now I'll move it to the bin. And then trace kills there. Nice. Okay, what was I to do now? Contract successful. Oh, that's not what I want. Get a copy and reply back. Sure. Substantiation. Excellent. Trace killed, as the name suggests, diverts active traces against you while it's running. Should make your work much easier. Let's begin. I've done some digging after the last set. You saw that message too. He knew what was going on. Anyway, just the idea of whatever happened was linked to his work was enough to start with. I did some tracking and he ended up with a bit of a list of his servers or relays. Can't know how many of them are just virtual boxes running off the same machine, but it's a good start. The most promising one is linked at the end of this. It's a personal work server, something he was using to privately host copies of the version control repositories he was working on, apparently. This itself might be a clue. Who keeps the backups of corporate VC solution? Only three cases I can think of. Either you're responsible if they fuck it up, and you're surrounded by incompetence and you want to be sure, or you need your backups and logs for legal reasons. Or you're worried about something and want records in case something goes down. Whatever the case, this seems like a place to start digging. Want to take a look? I've had a poke around but didn't turn up anything substantial. Can't decrypt the repo dumps. Let me know if you find anything. Send over the IP address for anything strange if you dig up a link. So that's here. Alright, save the game again. Let's start by having a little bit of a probe then, shall we? So I can close this. In fact, I can close the notes entirely. Let me go for it. Overload this and then webworm. Trace kill. Insufficient memory. Oh, whatever. Run that. FTP bounce. Let me try this trace kill after this because it is counting down quite quickly. If nothing else, let me see what it does. Suppression active. Okay, so that's paused it there. But I presume I can't run anything else at the same time. So if I do that, okay, and then if I exit, don't need this one. Now just bounce between servers. Yeah, I don't know how I feel about that. Anyway, I know what some stuff does, so that's fine. Log data. Don't need you. I wonder if you get anything for like downloading all the data files and doing something. Loot, Microsoft Docs. Okay, so let's notes, add note. Okay, so there's an IP address, it's interesting. Jesse McDonald's. Oh, McDonald's, not had any dinner yet. Booze. Some Leet Skills update. Okay, nothing there. Any sweet toys? FTPbounce.exe. I've got that done up. Oh, why am I in here? Ah, oh, I'm on the wrong server. Okay. It's like Microsoft. Yeah, I recognize that from earlier, but of course I do. Right, let's bounce between. Let's bounce back here. Log in. Tenzin. Okay, so let's go back to listing stuff. So. Data. It's just numbers. Keyboard test. Click. Okay, not too exciting work. Okay, so let's hub this. hn_repo_archive.deck. Is it decrypt or decipher? Decipher. hn_repo_archive.deck. And then probably tell me that it doesn't know the password, so we need a password. Bin sys. Anything in the log already? Connection? That's me. Let's go through this again. Now, where would I be able to? Let's have a look at this. I can at least use the return. Hello, what the hops? Bin up. Hops. No, that doesn't really help me trying to find the password. Put on my roving wizard hat. HN Repo Archive. Alright, well, let's delete the fact I was here. And this note's now useless, so you can get stuffed and close you. RN. What does RN mean? I'm gonna go back to the earlier email, see if there's any clues from bit in there. Page 2. Nope. Should be green screen. So get some tools. Now is it where to from here? Nope, nothing. Good idea in theory. So let me know if you find anything. Send over the IP address. So let's go back to my server here and view the file system. Now, what was the name of the header extractor? Let's head over into bin. Deck head, that was it. So if I go back to here, and deck head, and the file itself is okay. Let's see if we can get any more information out of it here. Okay, so a few headers here. So notes, add note 156.151.59.35. Boom. Sure, so let's connect. I'll tell you what, let's save it. Things just getting exciting. And maybe that's the IP address that they want, but let's see. Whoa, what does that say? Invidability error? Inviolability. Open ports require for crack. Okay, this place is pretty interesting, but obviously not what I'm after. So let me reply with the the details here, 156.151.59.35, and see what gets found out. So that seems to be successful. I've been around a while, but I've never seen anything like this. It's a bit early to call it unbreakable, but this is new. Different. Entech, huh? They make, what, a pretty mediocre antivirus? If they were selling whatever this is, they'd be making a fortune. Hey, look, the front end and stuff doesn't have anything this fancy. I'm going to get digging from the web server end. See at what point this new stuff starts. It looks like it's deep enough and that they're trying to hide it for some reason. No idea why, it looks like it will be a huge hassle to get past. Companies love that stuff. This is new and flashy too. This is suspicious as hell. Take a look on your end, see how far you can get in here. I don't know if it's just me, but this feels like a way better lead than even I was hoping for. Ping me back when you think you've seen as much as you can. Be thorough. Wow, that's good noise. Right, let's head over to this server here. Entech. The future in digital security. Sure, let's have a little probe around, shall we? This seems like it'll probably start bad stuff happening, so let's go with that. YOLO! And then SMTP 25. I should really figure out what ones take the most amount of time and not do that one. That fit in? No. FTP bounce 21. Like I said, SQL memory corrupt. Actually, I don't need to run that, but I'll run it anyway. Whatever one goes first. So this skill memory hack seems to be pretty quick as well, faster than the FTP one at least. And then we'll just bounce between servers again. So run, bounce, bounce. And we're in. So, nothing. Just more bash.orgs. I'm sure something useful in there sometimes. Any tools? Nope. Web index. Have a look at the thingy. Background color. Just reading through that. Images, Entech, logo hires, the PNG. Nope. No, it doesn't seem that useful. www.entech.com. Nothing in there. Okay, so there's nothing here. So let's do a quick scan, see if we can connect someone else. Whoa, hold up. Close you, add a note. So we have Zeus. 154.5.75.53.63 and then add note core 156.151.0.0 and then add note 156. sorry mail at 156.151.59.82. Okay, so there's a few places we can go now check out. Pretty sweet. Nobody's watching, that's fine. Don't know how long we've been playing for, what's the time? 9 o'clock, start at 8, not too long I don't think. Let's save that there. Pop into the log. Pretend I was never here. What's these places joined together? Now, the mail server is probably pretty interesting. Contractor relay system is probably pretty interesting. Web server, Zeus is interesting. Wait, what's this? Entech 151. No, oh, that wasn't on my list there. Add note. Relay. 156.151.59.35. I'm going to start there actually. So is this going to give me just nonsense? Okay. So new plan. Let's see if I can socially engineer something here. New. What happens if? Okay. Three X one IRG. Solve and let's overload. Should have started that already. But I still don't think I can get in anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Start that. If I solve them all, inviolability. FTP and then SSH 22. Fires up there. I'm pretty sure I'm not going to be able to get in anyway, so open additional ports. Certainly give me rather a long time. Open additional ports. Okay, so that doesn't help necessarily. Let's go over to the workstation core, I guess. Okay, so this isn't so bad. Gives me a way in at least. Should have time. Cancel. Do not get it. Ugh. I wonder then. So if I close. Don't really have the time. Go. Password found. What? Interesting. So after that I can kill the trace, I think. So let's probe. Okay, so now I can have a little look around. Yes, this is more along the lines of what I thought. You know, you have to run something in the background to get this going. That's nothing. System. There's nothing in here, is there? Oh no, here we go. No, it's bash, bash. I want a useful IRC log. Doesn't seem to be anything of consequence in here. What if I... Okay, so I can get... Oh, wow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more workstations up here. That's cool. So let's remove my 4 billion attempts at getting in. Deleting, deleting. Right, done. Then let's jump over to one of these workstations, I guess. So let's exit you. And then let's have a little proby woby. Oh, I need my shells back.
That's annoying.
Right, you'll do it. Shell. 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 And then back to here. Right, probe. Let me know. YOLO swag. Duh. 36 HDUF. How many ports do I need? Get that running time. See how it goes. Come on, come on, come on. Boop. Not gonna have time, not gonna have time. 4, 3, 2, boom. So murder. Did I make a note of the... So 36HDUF. Shell any more of these. Okay, so let's go back to here. So it's 36HDUF. And then solve 36HDUF. And then web port 80, and then SSH 22, and let's close, 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 and then KBT, address 104, and then trace, should have maybe run that one first. Come Come on. Ren, port hack, and then trace kill. Come on. Fine, trace kill. Go away. Boom. Right, so we're in. Sweet. I like how it steps up the difficulty of the game. Sitting on beanbags is not the most comfortable way of playing games. First of all, they really got a coffee table. Although it's like a mid height. It's not a desk. It's not particularly low down. It's kind of like sofa seat height. Pain. Right, what we got? Medstream ref. Mr. Giorioni has a serious heart condition. Okay. Prometheus. So with notes open, or is that gonna? Yeah, that's not so bad. Realistically, what did I get into there? So that was the core workstation 00. So let's close you. And then add note D88VANNX. Don't really know what that is. Prometheus. In fact, tell you, let's. Prometheus D88VANNX. Okay, so that's just. So that might be useful. The OS Hacknet netcore.dll. Well, let's have a copy of that. Hacknet, that's the game that I'm playing. Interesting. Let's see if there's any fun tools in here. Nothing. And nothing there. So let's just get rid of the log. And then we'll move on to the next workstation. Okay, so done there. So let's close that. This looks like one I can't get into. A probe it yet, so that doesn't matter. Can't get into there. Can't necessarily get into there. So Prometheus, I wonder if that's a... I can exit that now. So let's bring the notes back up. I wonder if that's a username password. Workcore. I mean, how much do I need to know before... Might as well log in. No, I've already got in there, didn't I? Workstation 1, Workstation 3, Prometheus. Let's try it. Prometheus, and then D88BANNX. So that doesn't work there. I mean, it's a bit optimistic that this is anything at this point. Prometheus D88VANNX. No, not good. Log in here. Prometheus D88VANNX. Okay, that's nothing. So, I'm going down here. I've tried those workstations. Web server, so that's where it started. The mail server. Prometheus D88VANNX. Nope. Was I able to get in here? Oh no, that's another nonsense one. Well, I think that's it. I'll tell you what, let's just... Might as well try them all. And then finally the external contractor. D88VANNX. Nothing. Okay, so probably learned as much as I can from here. Let's just save the game. And I will ping you back if you think you've seen as much as you can. Well, mission incomplete, so I've certainly missed something. I wonder, can I log in here still? No, cancel. Are you going to make me do it all again? That's annoying. I didn't do a scan on that computer, did I? Okay, well, let's get back in the hard way, I suppose. Not really going to make me get through the proxy area. Oh, now I can't even remember what the... So I'll do that first, and then... Something like 36HDUF. Right, solved, and then we'll just bugger off from there. I need to shell these things again. Shell. That'll do it. Right, probe. Solve. Solve that, and then KDT port test 104, and then SSH 2. Close. Port hack. Once it's done, there, and then trace kill. Once it's done, and then scan. Need to upgrade my MU. There was nothing there anyway. So what have I not done? Not the well, I might as well have a look around here again. Scan, nothing, definitely nothing. So let's view the files. Workstation store. Oh. To keep the stream on your desktop open. The operator works at Mr. Giorgione has a serious heart condition. Yeah, I mean, maybe I should store service. Ah, moron. Why didn't I look at the other things when I was in here? Can I add? No. Prometheus is at 156.151.1.1. That's me at my limit. And then add note Romulus. Well, here's what I tell you what, I don't need to save you. Really, so Romulus is at 56.151.1.12. I want to remiss this somewhere as well. Okay, that's fine. And then asset packs, should I download those? Here now, I suppose, asset pack 012.zip. I'll do the same again for 013. Alright. Okay, then back into logs. I don't know if anything bad would ever have happened to me if I never deleted these logs, but I suppose it might have. Okay, so let's connect to Prometheus. Connect at 156.151.1.1. And then if we log in with admin, and then D88VANNX. Boom shakalaka, we are in. In like Flynn. I could probably stop running you now. So scan the mail server. Session saved. Whoa. Hold up. Does that mean I've got an email? Are you seeing this network? There's that new security scattered about on almost everything, but I'm picking my way through it. There are still a few holes, but progress is slow. I've attached the IP of what I'm looking into now. From the side I'm coming at it, you can't see any cracks in it yet. Are you having any luck? If you find it's admin pass, reply to this email. With it, I get the feeling that server is the key to where Bit fits into all of this. The talk of this Hacknet project showing up is kind of worrying too. Have you ever heard of that? A whole OS rewrite. We can look into that later. For now, see if you can find a way into this relay. We'll work out what our next step after that. I'll probably look around the production store servers, Prometheus and Romulus, etc. A way in might be that way. Yeah, so where it was Prometheus. Here's Prometheus. And did Romulus moving off it. So log in. Yeah, that's fine. Remember to complete. View file system. See what we got. Never anything in there. Any sweet stuff? Nope. Store. Hacknet project. Whoa, what are all these? Right, Hacknet. Command connect. For use as a wrapper over remote connection channels, usually SSH. Combine connection methods to external services. Command should scan available ports and support services to find a valid connection method, then use it. Wrapping output to emulate a standardized connection. In effect, Hacknet's connection method should appear to be universal and standardized, when beneath it is capable of using all common and some uncommon connection methods to user services in almost anything. Test guide. Aside from connecting between workstations and the company's host server, you also need to support connecting to wireless and restricted OS devices. Our test plan includes connection services to several mobile devices, some cracked, other factory default. These devices are synced to the Prometheus server by support staff, and if you need one for testing, contact server team. So given the sensitive nature of the Hacknet project, just go through the Hacknet management mail relay. So add note HN manager at ntech.com. Okay, well, I can close you as well. Sync devices. US, wipe them all just in case. Better do it from here. Do not pair with other machines. Well, I'll tell you what I'm having. Let's have the Hacknet. Oh, wait, I've already downloaded this. Probably. File already exists or something. Transfer complete, that's fine. And the NSEC project. The insect inviolability, like inviolate ability, unable to be inviolate. Is that how you spell inviolability? Projects an OS level security layer through which all authentication attempts and admin commands pass that provides a uniquely protective level of security for systems against all conventional, many unconventional penetration and security breaching methods. Aims to be completely transparent to end users, except in case of emergency updates, which are maintained by NTech Inc. on a subscription basis. So paired with Hacknet, which seeks to demonstrate the flaws in current security systems, NSEC shows clearly why it should and will be the new accepted minimum standard of true digital security and confidence. So it seems like Hacknet's set up to just hack everything, and then they've got this new software to fix it. Well, let's grab this as well. Sure, so now I've got an email address. I don't have a password for it. Which is cool. However, probably going to take a break, be back on in around about 45 minutes. So that'll be about half, well, 40, at least it'll go 40 minutes, half past 10 I'll come back on. Save that there. And quit Hacknet. Alright, so this is face check currently jacking out.